sir. Good morning, respected colleagues. My name is Sakshi Prasad and I am here to present the case of idiopathic thrombocytopenic purpura. Coming with the case details, a 23-year-old female resident of Jaipur is coming in Bangalore, walks into the dermatology department with complaints of ecchymosis, gingival bleeding, and frequent bruising. She has a past history of migraine and mild hypertension and a family history of extreme hypertension. She had elevated levels of triglycerides and BMPL on routine checkups she took during work courses. Patient took atorvastatin 10 mg daily for a period of 1 month in order to overcome migraine and mild hypertension. She also complained of having mild Vinnytsia since the period of 2 to 3 weeks. Examination which followed showed the vital signs to becoming normal. There was gingival bleeding and mucous bleeding. There was ecchymosis on both right and left thighs and left leg. The differential diagnosis could be scurvy, dengue, leukemia, drug-induced thrombocytopenia, aplastic anemia, myeloproliferative disorder. A CBC which was conducted showed platelet count to be as low as 22,000 mm per kilo. It suggested thrombocytopenia. RBC and leukocyte count came normal. A bone marrow examination showed normal amount of megakaryocytes, which removed myeloproliferative disorders, anemia, and it suggested thrombocytopenia. Coming to the treatment, the therapy consisted of prednisone for a period of 4 weeks. The counts did come back to 2 grams per millimeter cube, but after tapering, the counts started decreasing. Upon increasing the dose again by 10 mg, the platelet count started rising. However, during the period of 4 weeks, the patient suffered from extreme side effects of steroids, which were fluid retention, weight gain of 15 kg within a period of 1 month, psychosis, confusion, delirium, severe drug-induced myopathy. In such case, the doctor suggested that the use of medicine such as thrombopath or robitussin. However, the cost efficiency was not something, the cost efficiency for the family was something that we looked up to, and thus a follow-up of 2 weeks was suggested. After 2 weeks, there was a significant increase in the number of platelets, even after the reduction of dose, twice by 10 mg daily. It was proposed that the 2 new drugs could be withheld. The case discussion. Thrombocytopenia can get spontaneously remitted in a period of 6 months in case of children. All the patients with thrombocytopenia, 50% of them are covered by children below 10 years of age, and it gets spontaneously remitted. No medication is required, no